Good afternoon, one and all. My name is Saumil Shah. In this video, I would be teaching you how to upload files, local files, to GCP bucket, that is Google Cloud Platform, right? Using Python SDK. So let's get started without wasting much of time. All right, here you can see I already have a few files here. In the previous tutorial, I taught you how to get the credential.json file, right? We learned how to download images and we also learned how to download bulk data using Python, right? Now let's basically upload data to the GCP buckets, right? So let's learn how to do that. So first of all, I'm gonna import a couple of libraries, right? We did this in the last tutorial as well. So I'm gonna go a little quick now. So what I need is, first of all, I wanna say import io from io import bytes io. Oops, the byte is capital, right? Then what I need is basically import pandas as pd, right? Except exceptions print. All right, and one of the module that is missing is, of course, the Google module. So I'm gonna say from Google.cloud import storage, because we are working with storage now. All right, guys, beautiful. Let's create a storage client. Let's create a client object. So of course it's, you know, that storage client dot from service, storage dot client, sorry, my bad. So let's do it again. So I would say storage dot client dot, then we'll say from service. Remember, we did this in the last video, right? And here I'm gonna give my JSON file the secret path, the keys, right? So where is that? Let me see. Yeah, first project. So I created here. Import that here. All right, we did this, right? Now let me collapse this so you can see the code part. Now what we need to do is basically we need to create a bucket object, right? All right, what I'll do is basically bucket. You know what, let's do this way. I'm gonna create a bucket, right? Object, right? Storage underscore client, right? Dot get buckets, right? And the bucket name, right? All right, now what we need to do is basically we need to upload a file, right? So let's define our file name. Let's say file name is equal to, let's do this way. We define our file name, right? String formatting. This is my name of the file. Just anything that you want to say. I'm just saying my.png. And then you create a blob object, so bucket.blob and file name. So you create a file name, a blob of file name, right? So once that is done, remember, we have the image, where is that, my image? Yeah, my image.png, that's my image that I want to upload, right? So what I'll do is I'll read the file with open, the name of the file, which is this one right here. We want to read this as a binary. We want to create an object of file, right? Now simply just say it's easy piece of cake, blob.upload of we'll say upload from a file, right? And pass in that blob object or that binary object, right? That's it, that's done. And let me just print upload complete, right? Let me just run this to show you that this works. So hopefully would have no errors. I think that there is no errors. That's the good thing. So upload complete. Let's move to our GCP bucket. I'm gonna refresh my bucket. And sure enough, you can see a folder here. Let's go inside that folder. And remember, we said my.png, right? And here we have the beautiful image. Oops, where is the image? Oh, it's gonna come. Maybe it's loading. So let me do that. Let me just go back. Go here. Right. And that's the image. Basically, we can download it, of course. So here you can see, say allow. My computer is actually a little slow. So here you can see beautiful image of my from the GCP bucket, right? So I taught you how to upload and download from GCP bucket. One more thing that I want to talk about is, instead, if you don't want to do this, you can directly upload a file, right, to the GCP buckets. So let's comment out this stuff. So if you don't want to do read binary, if you directly want to upload these files, so just provide the name of the file that is actually the actual name of the file, right, that you want to upload. So copy relative path. So myimage.png, is that the name? And hit the run button. And sure enough, this will also work, right? Both of the method works. So it's going to take a while because it's going to basically do all of these on the back side with open, what we did it right now, right? So hopefully that works. So did I run this? I don't know. So I think the process is finished and we should see image in that same folder if I ran the file correctly. You're sure enough, and we have the files right here, right? Cool. So we learned how to upload basically data to the buckets. We also learned how to download data from the buckets. If you do not haven't watched my videos to download it, the links would be there in the description. Please make sure to watch that out. Once again, thank you for your love and support. See you guys in the next video.